Welcome. The National Children's Science Congress provides a forum to the children to pursue their natural curiosity and to quench their thirst for curiosity. Our school, Sri Sanathan Dharam Vidyalaya and Junior College, Chembur, Mumbai, participates every year in National Children's Science Congress. In the year 2019, 9 projects from Mumbai district were selected for the national level of National Children's Science Congress. The National Children's Science Congress is the largest scientific initiative not only in India but also in the world, because at the district level, about 8 to 10 lakh children from all over India took part in it. It is organized every year by the Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India, New Delhi. Asim Gyan Vahini is launching a series of presentations of these 9 projects that were selected for national level and bagged 18 gold medals in the same. The purpose behind this is to introduce the genuine research work done by young scientists of the age group of 10 to 17 years in the world of education. This is one of the 9 videos in this series. In this video, the group leader Sneha Paran Kandar and group member Siddhi Dada Saheb Patil, two young researchers, are reporting their nationally selected research project. Title of the research is Useful Products from Banana Fiber, under the sub-theme Waste to Wealth. Now, let's hear about this project.
I, Sneha Kandar,
and I, Siddhi Patil,
we are from Sri Sanathan Dharam Vidyalaya and Junior College, Chembur, Mumbai.
We did our project on extraction of banana fiber and making useful products from it under the sub-theme of Waste to Wealth. The hypothesis of our project are: banana fiber can be used for making sanitary pads as it can absorb water due to the hydroxyl group present in the chemical structure. Cellulose present in the chemical structure of banana fiber can absorb oil from water. Banana fiber can replace wood fiber due to the property of flexibility and stiffness. Banana stem juice can be used as a beverage. Our project aims at providing extra income to the farmers and the rural women of India. The main aim of our project is to provide low-cost, skin-friendly, eco-friendly and hygienic sanitary pads to the rural women of India. We have also tried to save our Mother Earth by making organic paper using banana fiber instead of wood fiber. Now, let us see the other objectives of our project. Using the oil absorbency property of banana fiber for fixing oil spills. Using banana fiber which is recyclable and degradable in the place of wood fiber for making organic paper. Testing whether large cellulose content of banana soda stem juice can serve the purpose of an ideal sports beverage. Banana soda stem, when mixed with natural or synthetic dyes, serve as an excellent mordant for fixing dyes on the cloth, silk and woolen clothes. To stop cruelty towards animals, we have made biodegradable leather substitute using banana fiber. India is the largest producer of banana in the world, and banana is the fifth largest agricultural commodity. The pseudostem or banana plant is the stem which provides and transports nutrients from the soil to the fruit. This pseudostem will become a waste biomass after the banana fruit is ripened and harvested. In our project, we have extracted banana fiber from the pseudostem, which is otherwise an agricultural waste.
We use the following method to extract banana fiber: harvesting banana pseudostem, peeling intestine left from stem and cutting fiber and making pulp, then straining pulp and making sanitary pad and paper. After crushing and cleaning, separating of fiber from the sheets manually, and it can be done with the help of machines, the banana fiber were made into small pieces and then made into a pulp. This pulp was strained and dried to make organic paper and sanitary pads. In India, many rural women are not able to do outside jobs during their menstrual cycle as the sanitary pads are costly. Through our project, we could make a low-cost, skin-friendly, eco-friendly and hygienic sanitary pads to the rural women of India.
Properties like low alpha cellulose content and longer fiber length were best suited for using banana fiber for making organic paper. The presence of hollow structure and hydroxyl group in the chemical structure of banana fiber helped us in using banana fiber for making sanitary pads. Then we understood that banana fiber can absorb both oil and water. This made us to think of using banana fiber for fixing oil spills. But the drawback was that banana fiber will absorb both oil and water. A solution to this problem was treating banana fiber with acetic anhydride will convert the hydroxyl group present into it into acetates, which does not attract water. To test the absorbency property, we took 2 ml of petrol and 20 ml of water, and with the help of banana fiber, we could absorb all the oil from the water. The absorption took place at a slow rate.
Then we continued our research and found out that leather substitute can be prepared using banana fiber. For this, we fermented coconut water for 10 to 15 days and we could see a gelatinous substance produced in it. This gelatinous substance, when mixed with banana fiber, gave a leather substitute. Things like purse, wallet, sandals, etc. were made using this leather substitute. The biggest success of making the leather substitute is that it is biodegradable, which can save our Mother Earth.
In industries where banana pseudostem sap is produced, banana fiber is a waste material. And in industries where banana fiber is extracted, banana pseudostem sap is a waste material. This made me more curious to know more about banana pseudostem sap. Banana pseudostem sap is made up of hollow cellulose, hemicellulose, cellulose, lignin and tannin content, which may give fixing properties to the banana pseudostem sap. This made us to think of using banana pseudostem sap as a natural model. I prepared natural dyes at home using pomegranate peels, beetroot peels and orange peels. These peels were boiled in distilled water at 80 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. Then I mixed banana pseudostem sap to the natural dyes to test whether it can be used as a natural model. A cotton cloth was boiled in the solution of banana pseudostem sap and natural dyes for 30 minutes, and we could see that the synthetic the dyes were completely stripped to the cloth in the case of synthetic dyes. While transferring the dyes from the water to the fabric, only 80% of the dye gets fixed to the cloth, and the dye stuff which is not affixed to the cloth gets washed into the rivers. This causes lack of drinking water.
Then lastly, I would like to conclude that hollow structure and presence of hydroxyl groups in the chemical structure of cellulose helped us in making sanitary pads and made us to think of using banana fiber for fixing oil spills. Properties like hollow structure, cellulose content and lignin and longer fiber length helped us in making organic paper using banana fiber. Using the flexibility property of banana fiber, we could make rope and table mat. We could also make biodegradable leather substitute from banana fiber. Things like purse, sandals, wallet, etc. were made using this leather substitute, which are completely degradable in 2 months. This composition of banana pseudostem sap, hollow cellulose, hemicellulose, cellulose, lignin, and tannin content helped us to use banana pseudostem sap as a modern for fixing dyes on fabrics.
Thank you.
There are many more personalities behind this success. The General Secretary, Shri Upadesh Kumar Sharma ji, believes in education as a means to bring change and progress in the society. Sir motivates the students by taking personal interest in all the activities. He has given 4 D's to students as the key to success: devotion, dedication, determination, and discipline. The principal of our school, Mrs. Savita Sonasariya, who inspires and guides the staff by setting example of perseverance, principles and positivity. Guide teacher Mrs. Uma Nambiar is one of the finest science teacher. She comes up with novel ideas and magically bring her thoughts to life through her projects. This scientific approach of hers is really a boon for students. But at the same time, the guidance and hard work of the local organizers of this initiative is also important. From this point of view, the project was able to take off to the national level with the valuable guidance of Nav Nirman Vikyan Prabodhan, the Mumbai-based coordinating body of this activity, and Shri Balasaheb Jadhav, the Mumbai division head of the NCSE. It is very interesting to know some statistics of this year 2019. 301 science projects had participated in this competition at the district level. The projects were presented and evaluated in the grand function of District Level Children Science Conference held at Sri Amulak Amichand High School in Matunga. This event was inaugurated by the hands of Dr. Siddhivinayak Barve, Deputy Director of Kelkar Vase College, Mulund. Shri B.B. Jadhav and Mrs. Uma Chowdhury were the conveners of this program. Out of these 301 projects, 20 projects were selected for the pre-state level and then 13 projects for the state level competition at Belley near Pune. At the state level, 84 projects from across the state were in competition. Out of these 84 projects, 13 projects were from Mumbai. A total of 30 projects were selected for the national level by the state level of Maharashtra. The national level was organized during December 27 to December 31, 2019 in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. All these 9 projects received good publicity from the local newspapers of Mumbai. All 9 young scientists, their guide teachers and principals were felicitated on 27 February in the Ban Sangs SM Shetty High School, Pawai, by the hands of Dr. Anil Manekar, Member Secretary of Rajiv Gandhi Science Commission, Senior Scientist of Baba Atomic Research Center, Dr. Santosh Takle, Convener of the program, B.B. Jadhav, and Principal of Ho School, Seema Sablok, were also present in the function. This was a success story of Sneha Paran Kandar and Siddhi Dada Sahib Patil from Sri Sanatan Dharam Vidyalaya and Junior College, Chembur, Mumbai, from district level to national level. This story is an example of knowledge, skills, efforts, dedication, and persistences. Thank you for watching our video.